We are learning more today about the president's crude and arguably racist remarks in the Oval Office, in which, in the context of immigration, Mr. Trump expressed a desire for fewer people from majority black and brown countries to come to the United States. A source familiar with the remarks tells me that the conversation with the president, Trump administration officials, and a bipartisan group of members of Congress turned at one point to those immigrants here in the United States who have what's called temporary protected status, specifically Salvadorans, Hondurans, and Haitians. The president said, according to my source, "Haitians, why do we need more Haitians? Take them out," meaning take them out of the immigration deal being negotiated. Now, that is not quite how the president sounded when he was trying to get the votes of Haitian Americans in the key battleground state of Florida back in October 2016.
I'll tell you what, I just left Little Haiti. The love is unbelievable. It's unbelievable. There's no racist, there's no nothing. It's love. They want solutions. They want better lives, not more petty attacks from failed and totally discredited politicians like crooked Hillary Clinton.
And in the Department of Bad Timing today, in fact, this very hour, is the 8th anniversary of the devastating Haitian earthquake that killed at least 220,000 people and prompted the United States to welcome almost 59,000 Haitians under temporary protected status. Now, at another point in the conversation, my source tells me, and parents might want to hit the mute button for the next few minutes, the topic turned to the diversity lottery program and people coming from Africa. And that's when President Trump asked, as first reported in the Washington Post, "Why are we having all these people from shithole countries come here?" unquote. The president then suggested the United States would be better with more immigrants from places such as Norway instead of Africa. A White House official tells CNN that the president took a victory lap last night, calling friends and allies to get their opinion on the breaking news. Well, you know who loved the news? Racists. Racists such as David Duke tweeting, "Trump spoke blunt, hard truth." And racists such as Richard Spencer saying of Haiti, quote, "The problem is it's filled with shithole people. If the French dominated, they could make it great again. Hashtag make Haiti great again." The neo-Nazi Daily Stormer website said, quote, "This is encouraging and refreshing as it indicates Trump is more or less on the same page as us with regards to race and immigration. The real issue is all of these shitty brown people who come to the country exclusively to parasite off of us," unquote, and disgusting. This morning, however, the president tweeted, quote, "The language used by me at the DACA immigration meeting was tough, but this was not the language used." The president's ambiguity there seems a bit deliberate, since some of the original reporting conflated what he had said about the 54 nations of Africa and what he said about Haiti. So to be clear, he objected to Haitians coming to the U.S., but it was African countries that he specifically called shitholes. The president also tweeted in part, quote, "Never said anything derogatory about Haitians," which is technically true, I suppose. He just expressed the opinion that the United States doesn't need more of them. He's being a bit cute there with his non-denial denials. But Senator Dick Durbin, Democrat of Illinois, who was in the room, he did not mince words today about what he heard in the Oval Office.
In the course of his comments, said things which were hate-filled, vile, and racist. He used those words advisedly. I understand how powerful they are, but I cannot believe that in the history of the White House, in that Oval Office, any president has ever spoken the words that I personally heard our president speak yesterday.
Senator Durbin might want to read up a bit more on previous presidents, but be that as it may, Republican Senator Jeff Flake today, who was told of the remarks by Durbin and a Republican senator in the room, he told me, quote, "The words used by the president as related to me directly following the meeting by those in attendance were not tough. They were abhorrent and repulsive. There is no good explanation," unquote. Now, one explanation offered by President Trump and his defenders is that he wants to go to a merit-based system of immigration and not admit immigrants based on the country that they're from. But that's not what the president was arguing. And one might note that being born in Norway is not a particular achievement of any sort. In fact, according to the U.S. Census, more than 60% of people with Nigerian ancestry, age 25 and older, have a bachelor's degree or higher, and that's more than twice the U.S. rate of 28.5%. So the question, why the objection by the president to people from majority black countries coming to the United States? Well, this doesn't happen in a vacuum. It's of a piece. He's a real estate developer who was sued by the Justice Department during the Nixon administration for not admitting black tenants. He led a political campaign claiming falsely that the first African-American president was born in Africa. He has described Mexicans as rapists and drug dealers, and I suppose some of them are good people. And he said a judge of Hispanic heritage born in Indiana couldn't do his job properly because, quote, he's a Mexican. And on and on and on. Now, the president's favorite network has been offering a vociferous defense of the president's crass remarks.
This is how the forgotten men and women in America talk at the bar. This is how Trump relates to people.
This is how the forgotten men and women of America talk at the bar. Well, there is a word for people who go to bars and denigrate black people, but the word is not forgotten.